sufficient. It wasn't sufficient that he was down as a Dutchman in his passport. Now, at first blush, you may say, well, that makes no sense. But in fact, the Yeltsin court was not quite so quick to make a decision. It gave the example of the case of a person who had served as consul to Sweden in the South American, in an American country, wasn't it? But who, in a pint, should not be appointed as a solar in a case involving one Swedish party. Even though this individual was not Swedish himself and had never set foot in Sweden. So in other words, there can be a certain nexus with the country. Spend a great deal of time there if you're engaged with that country in some way. And it may make it inappropriate, not on nationality grounds, but simply on cultural grounds, not to appoint that individual. Professional and personal relations, these are quite difficult. In a dispute arising out of claims made under an insurance policy, the claimant challenged the arbitrator nominated by the respondent on the grounds that the respondent's lawyers repeatedly select this arbitrator, both as arbitrator and as counsel, albeit in unrelated matters. In his defence, the challenged arbitrator argued, among other things, that it was commonplace for any leading insurance Queen's counsel. Of course, when we come to discuss questions of conflict, you always have to remember that English Queen's Counsel consider themselves to have a particularly important and distinct role from the mere mortals, but that's another matter. Commonplace, he said, for leading insurance QC to act for and against the London market, that he would receive instructions or inquiries from many London solicitors. But the division of the court was at pains to stress, and I quote, one needs to look as to how the facts of the case could reasonably be viewed through the eyes of a fair-minded and informed observer who was unaccustomed to the behavioural norms and working relationships of the UK bar and local solicitors, noting that also that the fair-minded and informed observer should not be assumed to be as fully attuned with the local traditions and culture of the London insurance market as a member of the insurance community, or to be wholly uncritical. In the circumstances, that arbitrator was removed, much to his chagrin. The very last point I'm going to make, with the indulgence, and I know it's just straight over my time, is just a cautionary tale, really. And this is a situation in which an arbitrator was challenged, and it was challenged on rather flimsy grounds. But the reaction of that arbitrator to being challenged, was to damn to hell in writing the challenging party in such intemperate language as would make your hair curl. And the division of the LCI court considered the challenge and said it was without merit. But the challenged arbitrator, having reacted so violently to being challenged and done so in addition to writing, they considered no longer to be a suitable arbitrator to sit. So my caution to those of you who sit as arbitrators, some challenges can be extremely pointed and unkind.